a helicopter rescue crew scrambles. They can get there in about an hour.
They told us that there was a tanker on fire. That's kind of on the extreme end of what we typically respond to.
It's extremely rare to go out to a rescue and have some fire element exposed to you. Usually by the time you get there, the fire is out.
It will be up to rescue swimmer Dave Catterett to go into the water.
It felt like this was my show, like I was going to be doing the rescuing of these people. So I felt a ton of pressure.
The crew is flying into the unknown. The flames are spreading fast as Lugin makes his way down to a lower deck.
What I see is just like a Titanic, the movie Titanic. It's sinking on the bow, and the aft portion is going up.
The captain and most surviving crew have already gone to the icy cold sea. Three are still clinging to the rails, an engineer, a seaman, and Dominator, the ship's cook.
We have to jump in the water, let's go!
They're ready to jump, but Lugin stops them.
Do not jump! Do not jump!
And I told them not to jump because the ship is very high to jump to the life raft.
He's decided to be the captain now, and he's gonna be in charge. No, don't get in the water yet. Wait till the boat gets lower.
Don't jump!
So that, let's stay on the sinking, burning boat a little bit longer. Was a pretty cool move and a pretty collected idea.
I waited for the ship to sink a little bit.
His decision buys some precious seconds to reach the life raft before the frigid water takes hold.
Jump here!
And the second engineer, I helped him to get inside the raft.
They've managed to get into the life raft. Anyone else able to get off the ship is now floating in the near freezing, toxic sea.
There's a thing that happens in very cold water called cold incapacitation. It sucks the heat from your muscles and that slows your nerves. And in about 10 to 15 minutes, you simply can't move.
Suddenly, the life raft hit something. And we saw two crew members, and we helped them carry on board the life raft.
Help me! Help me!
We can hear people shouting for help, but you cannot do anything.
In a raft, you can't really get to them.
Over here!
A raft is built not to move. It's got ballast bags on it.
I'm here!
There's fuel oil, bunker oil, a million gallons of ethanol floating around. I can't imagine a worse situation.
Fumes from all the engine oil and ethanol are streaming into the life raft, threatening to overwhelm the survivors. High above, a C-130 equipped with thermal imaging surveils the site.
The C-130 that was flying overhead had an infrared imager that allowed them to see the heat signature from a survivor or a victim that was floating in the water.
They spot white traces in a life raft. It's Lugin and his small group clinging to life.
Target has been found. Target's been found.
I have eyes on target.
Once you transition from a search mode to a rescue mode, your adrenaline spikes. This is why you join Coast Guard Aviation, to actually save a life.
When the rescuers lower into position, they're surprised by the strength of the chemical fumes.
Once we did get on scene, The water had vapors coming off of it, kind of burned the back of your throat.
Whoa! Get a load of that!
You could kind of smell like rubbing alcohol.
The biggest problem we were facing was these fumes were just coming in the cockpit.
It was a hazardous environment. It was not a good place to be.
They know the survivors desperately need help, but it might be too dangerous to go in.
Is this something we're willing to risk our lives for?
As the chemical tanker Baumariner sinks into the Atlantic, six men are fighting the freezing cold and the deadly fumes spreading across the water.
We huddle together to eliminate heat loss. And the two person we carry from the water, they're not moving anymore.
Coast Guard rescuers have arrived on scene, but they can't come too close.
The helicopter puts out hurricane force winds underneath us. And the concern was that those hurricane force winds might blow the life raft over, capsize it.
We heard the noise of the helicopter. And we're hoping that those two guys are still alive.
We knew they didn't have all that long, and the way things were going, we were pretty convinced that if we didn't do something kind of fast, they were gonna die.
The only way to save them is to put rescue swimmer Dave Catterett into the water. But the team's afraid it's too dangerous.
I don't know, Dave. This isn't looking good.
The pilots, they did not want me to go down there. Everybody was firmly against me going down there because they were feeling the effects and they weren't even in the water. So if I got down there, who knows what would happen.
It's a risk Dave's prepared to take.
Hey, pull me in!
He assures the team he'll stay hooked to the helicopter at all times.
We'll do what we call direct deployment, which is I don't come off the hook. I stay connected to the helicopter. So if these chemicals just overwhelm me, they would just reel me right back up like a fishing line.
As Dave is lowered, there's another danger. The gas vapor on the water is also flammable. A helicopter in flight builds up static electricity. That electricity can surge along the same line, lowering Dave.
This electricity will discharge through me into the water, creating a spark. And all these other chemicals that were in the water possibly could have ignited and blown up our helicopter, blown up the people we were trying to rescue.
Over here!
I hit the water. There's no spark. It's overwhelming how many chemicals are in the water. It's almost like being intensely drunk, just immediately. I'm not able to get these people close enough to me where I can grab them. So I disconnect from the aircraft.
He's off the cable! Dave's off the cable!
I was really scared for Dave. He's exerting himself by swimming hundreds of yards in freezing cold water and breathing all that stuff in the whole time he's doing it.
I was in this race against time. The longer I spent in the water, the more likely I was not going to come back.
US Coast Guard, I'm here to help.
Inside, everything's covered with oil.
There's six of us.
Okay. I'm going to get you out of here, okay?
You say one at a time, just keep calm, don't panic, and everything will be lifted to the chopper.
Okay, here you guys.
All right, let's get you home.
It's so cold. The water's very cold.
One by one, the six men are hoisted aboard. Some are in critical condition.
You okay? Yeah.
The sixth survivor, he had no white in his eyes. When he opened his mouth, all that came out was oil. It looked like a horror movie.